But when we meet such person, we are not able to recognize immediately that we are standing next to monster. So you will pay for your imperfection. I love you. I adore you, my darling. I was already on hook. Don't dare to cheat on me. Otherwise, I'll hit you. Hello, my friend. Nice to see you on my channel. My name is Lisa, and last time I shot a video about criticism and raised the issue of setting personal boundaries. Today I want to share my experience and probably warn you against entering into toxic relationship. As a person who have never previously encountered such thing as narcissistic personality disorder, I miraculously crawled out of relationship that could have ended for me with a total destruction of my personality. It turns out that at first glance, very nice and interesting person can be a real nightmare. And if not pathological psychopath, then, for example, an ordinary narcissist. I won't be talking too much about who narcissistic personalities are. There is a lot of information on YouTube, but so that you understand what is being discussed, I will say what I learned about it. These are people with a mental personality disorder, with the following traits of character as sense of self-grandiosity and exceptionalism, lack of empathy, demand for constant admiration of their unique talents and achievements, an extremely negative attitude to criticism, and envy of other people's success. And you may say, big deal, an ordinary person with an inferiority complex. But the problem is that deep down they are extremely unhappy people who consider themselves miserable, worthless, who hide aggression inside, and is projected in ugly form on other people. Abuse, gaslighting, devaluation, in case of interaction with a toxic type of narcissist, physical injuries. The roots of the problems of such people is, of course, an unhappy childhood, less often genetic predisposition. More often you can find such personalities among men than women, and these are boys who were brought up by a single parent, mother. Often an overbearing, strict, or vice versa, mother strangling her son with overprotection.
I won't do it again.
Open your mouth. Now, stick out your tongue. Further, you little baby. Come on, be a man.
As I will talk about my experience, I will be talking about narcissistic men, but there are a lot of ladies of this kind as well. So, sorry, my lovely gentlemen. The theory is certainly good, but when we meet such person, we are not able to recognize immediately that we are standing next to monster. Of course, these are also people, and personalities with NPD are very different. Exhibitionists, coverts, perverts, toxic type, and so on. My task is to convey the main idea how to recognize that you deal with narcissists at the early stage of relations. I'll have to tell you some intimate details of my life, but I will do anything to help people. I believe that specific examples always help to absorb information more easily. So, let's get started. First sign that doesn't guarantee that you have met narcissus, but is a red flag, is that man struggles to gain your trust. He literally envelops you with his attention, pours compliments, writes 24 hours a day, tries to establish very close contact with you. This may push you away, but you will think, oh well, this guy probably has a crush on me. He is interesting to me and he seems to have the best intentions. At the same time, the person will almost immediately ask some very intimate questions about you. What do you love? What offends you? What are you afraid of? What infuriates you? Narcissists with whom I had a bitter experience lived in other city, and during the first meeting with him, I even didn't remember his name. He seemed so insignificant to me, but he just started writing to me like crazy in love and made video calls, gave compliments. He also described how good it would be for us together, asked to trust him that now I could be safe. He literally hypnotized me with his gaze, and I'm not kidding. And which woman doesn't like sincere compliments? Which one doesn't want to believe in trusting relationship. In general, the narcissist in the first stage of so-called honeymoon is trying to please you and satisfy all your needs. It seems that person is madly in love, and this is very charming. And you won't notice how you deeply fall in love with him too.
I know him so well, Alona. I know he's a very successful person and terribly well-educated, and he's gentle, kind, soft-spoken. I know all this about him and so much more.
But you can't even imagine what your sincerity might turn into. Narcissus will use your secrets against you. He can make fun of you in public, pull your strings and manipulate. But at early stage, it's very difficult to believe in. And by the way, I want to specially note that people with NPD choose very beautiful, bright, energetic people as their victims. They envy them and want to possess the same qualities, but they realize their worthlessness. It's freezing them out and they begin to humiliate and trying to suppress, literally destroy the object of their admiration. Okay, let's move on. The second bell, which says that not everything is so cool in his attitude towards you, is a small, sometimes innocent request to change something in yourself. You are being convinced that something is not quite right with you, and if you change this, then you will become just perfect. The man assures you that he cares so much and wishes you only the best. Well, for example, when my narcissist pampered me with the dates in cafe, he didn't like that I'm vegetarian. He literally made a mockery of it and said, well, we will fix it. Then he found out that I hate cooking and I will never like it. And he said that he will teach me and I will cook and will definitely like it. You think I've never tried too in my life, I'm 31. It seems such an innocent, friendly remarks, but it means that the person doesn't accept you as you are. Believe me, these remarks will result in humiliating criticism and sometimes public. I guarantee you will pay for your imperfection. The next red flag is very dodgy behavior. Person can very quickly make love confession to you. I love you, I adore you, my darling. Or go on passionate reproachment. He needs to know that you are hooked by him. Unfortunately, when we are in love, we also like all this stuff and it's difficult to cope with emotions. But in fact, narcissistic persons are not able to love. They don't believe in love. They have no empathy, no depth in their feelings. Because their psyche is frozen, blocked with traumas. It hurts so that person will never admit it and will be playing the role of his ideal identity. This is the reason why NPD is difficult to cure. Person sincerely believes that he is better than others and that he is always right. They perceive people as a resource, and often temporary. Your love for them is another trophy in their collection. You will never guess that they have a whole queue of the same charmed victims. In general, almost all narcissists have promiscuous sexual relations. They are extremely polygamous and dream of the whole harem, where everybody will adore and exalt them. Love of one person is not enough for them. What for? They don't know how to love even themselves. At the very first dating, my narcissist took my hand and said how he liked being with me like with no one before. After 10 minutes, he was already trying to kiss me right at the bus stop. And at night, it's better not to tell you, but immediately after all this ocean of tenderness and passion, he stated with serious face that he didn't believe in love between man and woman. Probably at that moment, I should immediately call taxi and leave, but I was already on hook and thought that he was just talking nonsense because he was looking at me with goo-goo eyes. The next day, the show began. He constantly flirted with other women everywhere, with waitresses, passers-by. I didn't dilly-dally around and began to flirt with all men. In general, I adore this thing, to be honest, but I didn't expect what follows next. I was extremely surprised when he, literally trembling with rage, declared, "Don't dare to cheat on me, otherwise I'll hit you. I can and you can't." I just laughed in response, but at that moment I realized that this dude wasn't joking at all, and he is not all right with his head. Whew. Next red flag appears a little bit later in relationship. The narcissist is trying to isolate you from communicating with your loved ones, so that they don't influence on you, don't see that something is wrong in your relationship. Indeed, from the side you can see better. Isolation takes place in the form of care. Don't go to the bar with friends, it's useless, they just gossip and drink. Your mother always picks on you, and you don't see that your girlfriend envies you. Listen to me, I'm the one who wishes you good, you can trust me. At the beginning of relations, in public, NPD persons are extremely pleasant, they play very well and adapt to the situation, and at home they can make a scene. The main thing here is not lose your identity, your interests, to remember that you have your own life, no matter how deeply in love you are. I got totally lost in the rooms with my narcissists, forgot about everything in the world, and all my plans were connected with this guy. But my romance lasted only 2 or 3 weeks, so I didn't lose much time. But some people are living with people with NPD for years. Sometimes they abandon their favorite business at their request, because narcissists devalues all your interests and talents. But this doesn't happen right away, of course. First, he lures you into his trap. If after all the screaming signs, you still believe that he will become normal and begin serious relationship with him, then I'm very sorry, but there will be a period of complete depreciation, abuse, and gaslighting, when you generally cease to trust yourself and your feelings, because narcissist never pleads guilty and turns the situation around so that you will consider yourself guilty, hysterical, suspicious bitch, and so on. I remember how it started to me. Damn, I'm so glad that he revealed his true face so fast. Otherwise, I would still probably be tormented. At first, this guy tried to devalue my mind in a very stupid way. He asked if I had read one book. I won't name which one. It turned out that I hadn't. Why should I read everything in the world? He indignantly blurted out. Are you stupid? Why you haven't read it? Well, I wasn't taken aback and asked in response. Have you studied Japanese? I've studied for 4 years. So you are stupid, dude. This is a very delirious situation. I don't know what person should be to admit the authority of such foolish person. And then he began gaslighting me. At that moment, I didn't even know about such term at all, but God endowed me with the extraordinary insight. I admit that I almost went nuts. And the thing was that this dude was so lovable that after sex with me, he could go to another woman at night. Last night when he was making love to me, he told me that he visited friends, but I didn't believe it. And later I found out whom he spent the night with. Never in my life I considered myself suspicious or jealous girl, maybe only in my youth. But here I couldn't do anything with the voice of intuition inside me. Baby, you are being deceived. You should know that at the same time he was very gentle, built joint plans for our future, and said that he wanted 3 children from me. Well, the last one, to be honest, only scared me off. Dude made the mistakes telling me about children. So I won't go into details, but then there were other revelations of his lies, and every time I told him that I knew everything, he accused me of excessive emotionality and mistrust. He was telling me, stop swinging on your emotional swings, baby, trust me. Oh, that was hard. But my sense of self-worth prevailed and I left the country for 2 weeks because this relationship brought me to nervous breakdown. He tried to assure me not to break up so quickly, think well, but I stood strong. Friends, can you imagine? In just 2 weeks, I went mad. Subsequently, I found out about this guy many details that finally convinced me that he was a psychopath. He almost brought one girl to the suicide. As far as I know, she's still adoring him and tagging along. I saw that girl. She is looking pale and constantly depressed, as a victim of a vampire. And you know, persons with NPD are true vampires. They are pumping energy from you. Narcissists also like to disappear without explanations, arrange the manipulation of silence, thereby cause a sense of guilt in the victim. The worst thing is that it may seem that you will never be the victim of such an abuser. But when you are inside trap, getting out of it is not so easy. So what's the kicker of narcissists? Why is it so easy to fall in love and difficult to get out of this relationship? It's all because of initial puppy love period. Narcissus told you that he adores you, loves you like no one else, that you are the one and only. After the following humiliation and depreciation, Narcissus knows well how to please you again. He is very handsy. He can send gifts, growl at your feet, if only you forgive him. And then he will reproach you with the fact that you were unkind and, in fact, it's you who are to blame for that conflict. After the rumors with that narcissist, I came across another one, this time at work. I saw through it almost immediately. He was simply inadequate. He didn't expect that I will somehow resist in response to his attempts to depreciate me, but of course he didn't apologize, only called me insane. Narcissistic personalities never admit they are guilty, only if they want to manipulate. This is really scary, especially if you are a young boy or a girl, self-insecure and haven't previously encountered manipulators. Sometimes we want someone stronger to help us, to lead us through life. We want to feel protected. But in the end, we can stumble upon a tyrant and lose our freedom in relations with him. The worst thing is when you already have children and joint property. I want to ask you, don't forget about your value and uniqueness. No one has the right to discount or make fun of your business, habits, and dreams. No one has the right to manipulate you for his own purposes. I urge everyone, especially women, to be extremely careful at the first stage of your relationship with a man. Don't rush things. You should get to know the person closer. Then you can avoid at least the loss of your nerves, as maximum, loss of your health. Narcissistic personalities are hard to be cured, as I said before, because they are depreciating even psychiatrists, so don't expect that they will change their behavior. If you also experienced relations with NPD persons, share your story under this video. And I want you to share my video with every friend you think may get into toxic relationship. Thumbs up, subscribe, and see you next time. Be happy, love, and be loved. Stay true and kind, the rest things never mind.